DaVinci Resolve 18 is upon us, guys. DaVinci Resolve is finally becoming an adult. I remember when I turned 18 and I thought I was finally becoming an adult, but actually, I was still just a dumbass. Good times, though. Anyway, what I want to show you is what you need to do before you start color grading in DaVinci Resolve 18, or 17 if you haven't downloaded 18 yet. Color management. So, you're about to color grade some log footage. Any log footage. It doesn't matter what camera. Canon C-Log, Sony S-Log, it doesn't matter. This is S-Log 3 from my Sony a7S III, and it looks like poop. Flat, no contrast, no saturation, poop. Now, I do hope that your poop doesn't actually look like that. You know, flat, no contrast, and no saturation, because you might want to go see a doctor. Or is it the other way around, when it does have contrast and saturation? I don't know. Interesting. Wow. So the first thing we need to do now is figure out what color space we're going to use. Now, if you're doing video, then chances are what you need is Rec. 709, because that's the standard for TV, broadcast, video. You know, the standard. And even if you're color grading for YouTube specifically, Rec. 709 is also a good choice. Even though, technically, I think that YouTube uses sRGB. But the differences between Rec. 709 and sRGB are so small that you're not gonna notice the difference that much. So just use Rec. 709 and you should be okay. And for the sake of keeping this video simple, I'm also gonna use Rec. 709. Okay, now how do you make sure that your project ends up looking perfect? The right colors, the correct color space. There's actually a few ways to do it. And first, I'm gonna show you how I used to do it, the wrong way. It's not the wrong way, but there are better ways. First of all, in your project settings, set the color science to DaVinci YRGB, DaVinci's own color space. And later, I'll show you this one, the color managed option. And then the timeline color space, Rec. 709, Gamma 2.4. Output same as timeline, so also Rec. 709 2.4. And remember, if you specifically want sRGB, then you change this to sRGB. But also remember, when in doubt, just use Rec. 709 for video. Okay, we're off to a good start now, but my S-Log footage still looks like poop. So what we need to do now is bring that log footage, that log profile, into the Rec. 709 color space. We need to make this look natural, like a normal image, not all flat and poopy. And I used to do this manually, which is possible. You adjust the curves and the log wheels to add contrast and add saturation, and at some point you'll end up with an image that looks like what it looked like when you shot the video, because that's what you basically want to do. You want to get a natural looking image. But doing it like this, manually, you really have to be experienced, and even then, it's pretty much just guessing, so not really ideal. A second way to do it is by using LUTs. And that's a much better way, because chances are that you can get LUTs for the camera that you have. Sony has LUTs to convert S-Log 3 into Rec. 709, for example, and it'll give you a correct result, but you need to download the correct versions of the LUTs, and I mean, you also have to know how to use LUTs. Do you put the LUT in the first node, or the last node, the second node? And there's nothing wrong with this approach, but I think there's a better way. Two ways, actually. First method, what I've been doing for a really long time, is using a color space transform. So you go to the color tab, and then up here, you look for the color space transform. Drop it on your node. And then, of course, you have to select the input color space. In this case, it was sgamut.cine3, input gamma slog 3, and then boom! This is a great starting point for your color grade, because this is a scientifically calculated correct image. And make sure that the tone mapping mode is set to DaVinci here, because otherwise, look, you might get tones and colors that jump out of that Rec. 709 color space. And the tone mapping will keep them in, will contain them. But the problem with this method is that you're working on a node level. And just like with the LUTs, you have to know how the nodes work. Do you put the color space transform in the first node or the last node? There's not really a correct answer for that. So for a beginner, it might be a bit confusing. So there's another way to do it, a much simpler way, less overwhelming if you're a beginner, and even I use it right now. So let's reset this node, go back to the project settings, and instead of the standard DaVinci Resolve color science, set it here to the color managed option. Then color processing to SDR, we're not gonna do HDR here, and output, of course, Rec 709. Hit save, and now there's two things that might happen. First of all, DaVinci Resolve might recognize your camera and the color profile that you used on your camera, and it will automatically bring the footage into the Rec 709 color space. And it will look great, automatically. You don't have to do anything. If you go here to the color tab and camera raw, this is where you'll see if it recognizes your camera and the color profile. If it doesn't, then all you need to do is right click on the clip here and select the input color space. In my case, sgamma3.cine/s-log3. And boom, image looks great. Scientifically correct. And if you have multiple clips, you can go to the media pool down here, select all your clips, and set the input color space for all of them to whatever you need. And now you have a great starting point for your color grade, without worrying about nodes and where to put color space transforms or LUTs. It will be automatically correct. And that's it, you're good to go. Wait, no, one more thing actually. If you want to do it correctly, use the right color space, Rec 709. Actually, ideally, what you also need is a monitor that has the Rec 709 color profile, because, you know, you need all your tools to be in the right color space. Whenever I'm editing my videos, I make sure that my monitor is set to Rec 709. There you go. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one, guys.